Do you want to know how to avoid musicians on your worship team who have bad attitudes, who come in late and don't just show up at all? Believe me, in my travels around the world, I've heard some terrible stories of worship team disasters. So I want to show you how to recruit good musicians with a good heart so your team is healthy and growing. The first thing you need to do is create a process. Almost any process will work. The most important thing is that you have one. With a process in place, it will create a standard and expectation for everyone. So when problems arise, then reference can be made to what was explained in the process. Some churches have a process of a month and others of 6 months. That process could include an interest meeting, an audition, an interview, discipleship, and community. So step one, the interest meeting. This is a meeting for those who want to know what's involved in being part of the worship team. It's a place to present the vision for the worship ministry in your local church. And at this meeting, clearly explain the purpose of the team. Why do you exist? Explain the expectations of those in worship ministry and the process to become involved. Step two, audition. This is where the interested person demonstrates their musical ability. And it could be an assignment for them to play or sing a certain song a certain way. It's not to show their improvisational skills, but can they play the song and follow instructions? That's the question. So this audition process can be done online with a simple video for the applicant to follow, and then they record themselves and upload the video or MP3. The third step is the interview. This is an opportunity to get to know the person who is applying. The interview could be done by someone in worship leadership who will ask questions about what the individual feels called to. How is their family life and their married life? Why do they want to join the worship department? This is the time to discern motives. Listen carefully to what they say. Out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaks. Number four, discipleship. This is part of the process that equips the applicant for worship ministry. You see, being a musician and having talent does not qualify someone for worship leadership. It does for performance, but worship is about spiritual encounter with God through music and involves the application of biblical principles. So develop a process of equipping the applicants for worship ministry, perhaps weekly for a minimum of 12 weeks. Go through a book or a curriculum that trains someone in effective worship ministry, giving the who, what, why, where, and how of worship. If you don't have one, I recommend the book Authentic, published by Gateway Church. This will equip a team in what the real worship looks like and will help them become worshipers. It's available at LamarBoschman.com or Amazon. Step five, chemistry. Get to know the applicant during this process. Watch them and discern their character. Do they fit well with others? Do you discern some issues in their life that should be addressed before you appoint them to ministry? And the final step, step six, appointment. When the process is complete, after praying over each one, the leadership team feels good about them, then confirm their place as members of the worship team. They could start in children's worship or youth worship. Other options for them is to begin in home groups or smaller meetings where worship is needed and watch them grow. Well, these practical steps are used by many well-known churches and will help you avoid future disasters, divisions, and bring a sense of commitment and community to your worship team. Your team will grow spiritually and musically with this process. And they will take serious the worship ministry and be more committed to the purpose of your team. So I pray that your team is healthy and growing, and these things will help you meet the goal of leading God's people into His revealed presence.